In this video, I will be making a new circuit board so I can add USB-C connector to the PS4 controller. USB-C connector is far more tolerable for rage quitting kids. It's a bit more sturdy, so that's what I'm going to try to do. This is the board that we're trying to get out. It's fairly easy to get the controller apart, and it's attached with a single screw. This is how the board looks, and here's the old USB micro connector, and here's the other side with the LEDs and all FPC connector. Doesn't have any parts, should be pretty easy. First thing that I'll try to do is just desolder the components. I'll just heat up the board and then just start to pick them off one by one. Then I'll grab some sandpaper, start to sand off the solder mask. Comes off pretty easily, goes pretty fast. And then you'll end up with something that looks like this. It's obviously a lot easier to see how the circuit board is, where all the traces go and that sort of thing. Then I'll put it in a normal photo scanner and just run the photo scanner on each side. Then I'll import it into this Photopea Photoshop online version. Then I'll just crop the image, and then I'll change the opacity on one of them so I can align them on top of each other, and I also flip one horizontally. That way I will have the same look as if it was in a circuit board program. And then I'll just put them on top of each other, just rotate them, and then it's quite easy to see how everything works. Then I'll just export it as high quality JPEG and store it on the computer for future reference. This is what I end up be using as reference while routing and creating the schematics for the board. I'll be creating the board in ECEDA. Just have to come up with a decent name for it, which is always hard. And then we'll start to source the components. We'll start off with a fuse, and then just find a fuse which is similar on LCSE and add that to the design. Fairly easy to find. And just place it in the schematics. Then we're adding the capacitor, which is a 4.7 microfarad capacitor. I like this from Taiyo Yuden, which are like black. And then it's the common mode filter, which I'm selecting from TDK. And then we also need a FPC connector, 0.5 millimeter pin. I'm choosing this from Hirose or Hirose. I really like Hirose connectors. They're pretty nice. I think they're Japanese. And then we have the RGB LED, which is basically three normal LEDs put together in the package. This was the absolute hardest one to find, so I basically had to just search for RGB and then just browse through everything. It's not one of those smart RGB lights. It's just three in one package. And then just add that to the schematic. Next thing up is to try to figure out what's connected through the FPC connector. Start with the power here. It's internally routed. This is a 4-layer board. And you see the top one is the V-bus, the 5 volts. And then you have the power for the LED. And then you have the return lines for the RGB LEDs, 3 of them. Diving into the other side of the board, going down through the side, and then diving up again on the other side where the RGB LED is. It's fairly easy to see when you have an image like this. Makes it a lot easier to just trace everything. Then it's the power again on the other side. Here's the V bus. And that dives into some internal routing up here where the fuses and also the decoupling capacitor. And here is the V bus coming in the USB connector. And then you have the data lines on the USB through the filter. And then you have the ground, which is connected through the ground plane. So this is how the schematic ended up looking. Fairly straightforward. Hopefully didn't do any mistakes here. But there's only one way to find out. Exporting it to the PCB layout, start to do that. First thing that I like to do with this board is to just take some measurements of the existing boards, because it needs to fit into the controller. Measuring the hole sizes, where the holes are located, and so on. And then I'll just write down the different measurements. And here is the measurements from inside the controller, which I found important. And then I'll add these white lines as the measurements to help a guide place the components. And I'll be creating the outline of the board at the very end. This is how everything ended up being in the end. If you would like to see how I usually route this board, I usually live stream on Twitch all of the routing that I'm doing. So when I'm routing something, I usually just start a stream. So if you want to get inside my head and see how I do this, you should check me out on Twitch. It's just twitch.tv MariusRH. So this is how the board visually is looking in the 3D export. The RGB LED doesn't have a 3D version, so it's not visible, but you can clearly see the USB-C connector here. So we're closing in on the design and we are about to order. However, there's just one more thing that I would like to do. That is to export the circuit board. I'll export it as a PDF. I'll remove the top layer, the top silk, and only exporting the board outline, the hole, and the bottom silk. Then I'll just use a free software online to convert the PDF to a DXF. which I then later can import to Fusion 360. When it's imported in Fusion 360, it doesn't get the right dimensions, so I just measure a certain distance that I know. This should be 8 mm, but it's 0.315, and then I just find the multiplier for it, and then I'll just scale it up. Once I've scaled it up, the only thing left is to extrude it and then export it. What's important here is to check if the USB-C connector fits in order to see how much I need to cut out from the controller. Then I'll just export this and 3D print it on a 3D printer. And then at the very end, I'll just be checking if it actually fits in the controller. I've grinded away some of the controller here in order to fit the USB-C connector, but it fits rather nice. So that's it for this video. I'll be making a new video when I be getting the board. I'll be ordering this from JLCPCB, which is also sponsoring this video. If you would like to see how this board looks when it arrives from JLCPCB, subscribe to the channel, hit that bell for notification, and you will be getting a notification when the new video is out of me assembling this and testing it and see if it works. If it works, I will be releasing the design as a free open source board you can actually order and own and build yourself.